Hello children, welcome back to your English class. Children, we are doing chapter 1, the best Christmas present in the world. In the previous video, children, we have discussed about the phrasal verbs and noun sentences. Okay, now in brief,
and out is a preposition here. So when we combine a preposition or verb or a verb or an adverb, it becomes phrasal verb. Fine children, like burn out. If we see separately the meaning of burn and out, the meaning of burn is something else, out is something else. But burn out, the phrasal verb means, burn out is to completely vanish or destroy something. So this is phrasal verb that we have already discussed in the previous video. Noun phrase, any noun accompanied by some adjectives. For example, a sweet, chubby elephant. So, a is the determiner here. Sweet, adjective. Chubby, adjective. Elephant is a noun. So, this noun is followed by two adjectives. So, this is a noun phrase. Fine, children? Now, in this video, we will discuss the comprehension check given on page number 10 and 14. Although, I have given you to do the comprehension check. Two questions are there given on page number 10, but still today we will discuss it. Now please open your books, children. Please open page number 10. This is the last part of section 1. This chapter is divided in 3 sections. So this comprehension check is for section 1. Now see question 1. What did the author find in a junk shop? Now, if you have seen the animation or if you have been through the chapter twice or thrice, so you must know that the author found a roll top desk in a junk shop. So it will be the answer. The author found a roll top desk in a junk shop. It's a factual question. Okay, no other answer will be the right answer for this question because the author found a roll top desk. If you can write the author found a scissor, no, it will be wrong. So this is a factual question. Fact is there. Second, what did he find in a secret drawer? Now, he found a small tin box in a secret drawer. Now, small tin box. Small tin box is what? This is a noun phrase. Noun is box and it is followed by small and tin. So, he found a small tin box in a secret drawer. Now, who do you think had put it in there? Now, this is an inferential question. No fact is given here. But as per your understanding of the chapter, when you trigger your mind, you will come to the answer that I think the owner of the roll top desk had put it in there. Okay, children? So these are the two questions, comprehension check of section 1. Now, for section 2 also, comprehension check is given on page number 14. Just open page number 14. See, 5 questions are there. First of all, who had written the letter to whom and when? 3 things have asked here. Who has written the letter? To whom and when? So, who has written the letter? John MacPherson had written the letter. to whom he has written? To his wife Connie. And when he had written the letter? On December 26, 1914. So frame the answer as per the question. How in the sequence, how it is asked in the question. Like, John MacPherson had written the letter to his wife Connie on December 26, 1914. Now second, why was the letter written and what was the wonderful thing that had happened? What was the wonderful thing? The wonderful thing was that the two armies, those were fighting with each other. Which two armies? The British and the German. The British army and the German army, those who were fighting with each other, they celebrated Christmas together. Yes, so that was the wonderful thing that had happened. Now, see the third one. What jobs did Hans Wolff and Jim MacPherson have when they were not soldiers? When they were not soldiers, Hans Wolff played cello in orchestra and Jim MacPherson was a teacher. Fine. Now, had Hans Wolff ever been to Dorset? No, he had never been to Dorset. Why did he say he knew it? Okay. Like, if he never been to Dorset, then why did he say? So, what you will write? No, Hans Wolff had never been to Dorset. Now, children, question 5. Do you think Jim MacPherson came back from the war? How do you know this? Now, the fact is not given in the chapter. It means it's a inferential question. You have to infer. Fine. So, do you think Jim MacPherson came back from the war? No. I think Jim MacPherson did not come back from the war. How do you know this? We know this because his wife Connie had preserved his letters. Yes? That is the only clue given in the chapter. So that we'll come to know that he is dead. So children, these 5 questions given on page number 14 and on page number 10, 2 questions. It means total 7 questions. You have to do it in your fair notebook. I hope everyone of you have done the new words. Just after the new words, you have to write down section 1, comprehension check, question 1, answer, question 2, answer. Then section 2, comprehension check, question 1, answer, 2, answer, 3, answer, 4, answer, and 5, answer. So that's it for this video. We'll meet again in the next video. Till then, take care of yourself. Have a nice day.